Hi everyone, welcome back to my lab. So in today's video, I'm going to be producing cesium metal in a way that is very similar to how I produce the sodium metal. But there are two main differences. First, I'm going to be using cesium chloride, which I have purchased rather cheaply online. And second, instead of sodium metal as my reducing agent, I'm going to be using lithium metal. The vapor pressure of molten lithium is lower than sodium, so my product should be more pure. So, let's get started. Let's just put these two together. Cesium chloride here. And then I'm going to be putting the lithium metal in on top. Now, cesium is more reactive than lithium, but since cesium's boiling point is so low, the cesium metal, as it reacts with the lithium metal, there'll be like an equilibrium process going on. Any cesium metal that is produced will immediately vaporize off and it'll be collected inside of my container. So here we go. Some lithium chunks going in on top of the cesium metal. And why not? Let's put a little bit more cesium in on top of that. All right. I'm not really measuring it. I think lithium in this case is going to be in excess. But this is just a test to see if I can do it. Let's put it all together, put it in the furnace, heat to 1200 degrees, and hopefully we get some cesium. Looks like not much has come out. Let's try warming up the metal tube here and see if we can get the cesium to flow. Maybe because it's a cold day, it's not coming out. Oh dear, something came out. And look, it's gold colored. That's cesium. So it looks like most of the cesium is finished distilling over. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to pull this off before too much air can get in there. I'm going to inject some mineral oil into the bottle just to protect the cesium so it doesn't react with the air too vigorously. So I've just set the bottle on top of the furnace here to warm it up a little bit. Now the cesium is liquid. Let's pull a little bit out of there and drop it into water, shall we? Okay. Here's a little bit of the cesium metal. There we go. It's fairly reactive. There's some tiny drops. It reacts quickly. It doesn't release a whole lot of energy, but the reaction is very fast. Watch what happens when I drop a bit of liquid cesium out onto the concrete. Isn't that cool? Let's try it again. The cesium not only reacts with water, it also reacts with the air. So it's on fire by the time it even gets there. And then it splatters, and then it's everywhere. But, like I said, the energy release is not that high, so reaction happens quickly, and it's over with. Look at how beautiful this is. It looks almost exactly like gold, except that it's a liquid. Isn't that cool? And I guess also it ignites on contact with air. I was amazed at how easy this was to make. You know, I didn't even have to exclude 100% of the air. A little bit of air and leaking in, and it was still okay. I'm not the first YouTuber to do this. In fact, Thunderfoot has also made a video about making cesium using a very similar method to what I did here. I'd recommend going to check him out if you're into the science videos. But yeah, I'm going to take this now and I'm going to go seal it inside of a glass tube so that I can keep it for later. So here it is, the tube that I've made with the cesium. Now unfortunately I didn't have any argon on hand, so I had to seal it along with air, which the cesium immediately consumed. And so the impurities are causing it to really stick to the glass. But still, you can see the golden color of it, and you can kind of play with it as a liquid here. I think that's pretty neat. So I'm going to leave you guys with some high-speed shots of me dropping the rest of the cesium into some water. And until next time, I'll see you then.